In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the centroid tile. So my first scenario is I have these four different stones. In this logic cube, I create an object set called rocks, and I add each of the stones. And I say, when there are items in this object set, the center of the rocks vector is equal to the centroid of that set. I'm going to display that vector at the top of the screen so we can see where it is. And then further to demonstrate where it is, we'll say for each of the rocks, draw a line from it to that center of the rocks vector position. So this is the point that's the middle of this group of rocks. And I can move the rocks around, and as you might expect, the center position will change based on the arrangement of the rocks. Centroid is a three-dimensional point, so if I put one of them up high, you see that it's not necessarily on the ground level. It's wherever that centermost position of the entire group is. This is the code that I'm using to move the stones around. I thought somebody might want to see that. My second scenario is up here. Again, I have four items. This time I have four goblins. And they add themselves to this object set called goblins that's stored in that logic cube. I have a TNT bundle here. I've changed its code from the default so that it'll explode when it hits the terrain, so when it hits the ground. So for this group of goblins, the center of the goblin's vector is equal to its centroid. Let me show you where a centroid is. On the second page under positioning, here's centroid. It's got a picture of four apples on it. So when I hold down the right trigger, we're going to say for each of those goblins, draw a line from it to the center of the goblin's position. And then when I release the right trigger, I'm going to throw one of these TNT bundles there. So I'm holding down right trigger. You can see as the goblins move, the centroid is constantly updated to wherever the center point position is. So when I release the trigger, so you can see as the goblins die, when their bodies are removed, the centroid updates. Oh, perfect. So I'm not targeting any particular goblin, just that center position between them. Let me kill off all but one of my goblins. So now the centroid is still being drawn, but because there's only one object in the set, it's being drawn from his center point to his position, which is between his feet. And when there are no goblins, there's no more center position, so no centroid. Syntax for centroid is a little bit strange. On the when side, you put the object set that you're trying to find the center of the group of. And then on the do side, you just use the centroid tile. And I usually assign it to a vector like this. This is probably the easiest way to use it in further lines, is to use it with a vector variable like that. So that's centroid. If you do anything cool with centroid, let me know. This was one of the only examples of a active action type game that I could think of using centroid. So I would love to see other uses of it.